सब नागा मनु के सलाम को यासे। It is an honor to be among you in this green and beautiful land of Kisama as we celebrate 54 years of statehood for Nagaland and the inauguration of the Hornbill Festival 2017. On this occasion of State Day, I extend my warm greetings and best wishes to the people of Nagaland. I wish you all a bright future full of peace and prosperity. I also congratulate the state government for organizing this festival of festivals, that is Hornbill Festival, to celebrate the State Day. I commend the Chief Minister and his team for such an impressive show. Friends, this is my first visit to Nagaland after having taken over as the President of India. I am glad it has coincided with what has become a flagship tourism event for the state and for our entire country. The Hornbill Festival is the perfect showcase of rich Naga culture and traditions preserved over the years in the form of music, dance and food. The Hornbill Festival at Kisama and the International Music Festival represent the diversity of Naga society. We have the best of traditional dance and music, and we have the best of modern musicians and artists. Today, we witnessed the glimpse of that richness full of diversity. I congratulate all the participants and performers for putting together such a brilliant display of Naga dance and music. Nagaland is truly enhancing. Anybody who comes here would not want to leave in a hurry. And I would urge tourists coming to this festival to purchase and take back with them some of the beautiful salts that this state is so famous for. As I understand, every tribe and community has skilled weavers who specialize in different styles of salts. Each is a marvel. In a time of machine-made products, Nagaland should justifiably be proud of such traditional and women's salts. They must reach a much wider market. Friends, the past half century has been one of both achievements and difficulties for Nagaland. The people of the state have come through many trials, but their essential talent and wisdom and their essential goodness has been so apparent. Today, Nagaland is at the edge of making history. After years of insurgency, there is hope. With this support of the people of the state, of civil society institutions and all the stakeholders, there is an opportunity for lasting peace. I congratulate all the Naga groups for having come so far. I am confident that a final agreement, one that is fair to all and meets the expectations and aspirations of all, will be reached soon. Today, there is a government in the state without any opposition. There is a unique situation. It also offers a chance to resolve long-standing political problems, bring lasting peace, and it can accelerate the process of development and of creating jobs and opportunities. Nagaland deserves this. All of you deserve it, and the young people of the state deserve it. The youth of Nagaland are the pride of the country. I see in them a quest and an aspiration to excel and be the best. They are the true legacy of Dr. T. Ao, the doctor sports person who was the first captain of our national football team after independence, leading the team in the London Olympics of 1948. Young people from Nagaland are role models for the rest of India. An illustrious daughter of this state, Tem Sutla Imsong, has won the hearts of the nation for her remarkable work in cleaning the ghats of River Ganga in Varanasi. Another Nagaland girl, Chievelo Thele, was adjudged the best trainee commando in her batch of police officers from Delhi Police. She was the poster girl in Delhi Police this year. And as Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, I must say, I am immensely proud of our Naga soldiers and officers. They are among the best we have. They have done the country great service. Friends, the key to Nagaland's development is infrastructure and connectivity projects. These will link Nagaland to new markets, both in India and abroad. That is one of the key goals of the Government of India's Act East policy and of its trust for connectivity in the states of the Northeast, including Nagaland. And Nagaland has so much to offer. The strength of the state lies in its organic farm produce, flowers, and fruits. Nagaland has rare medicinal plants and herbs that can help create jobs and boost the economy. And I cannot forget to mention Naga Jolokia, king chili locally. This is one of the hottest chili peppers of the world. We need to bottle it into one of the hottest selling sauces of the world. Nagaland has the potential to be an attractive tourist destination, offering a unique blend of heritage and culture and spectacular natural beauty. Another attribute of society here is the higher literacy rate. A young population that is fluent in English, comfortable with information technology, and forward looking can transport the state and the region into a hub for the services industries of the future. Our country is making great strides in every area: business, trade, education, and culture. We are among the world's fastest growing economies. We are also a diverse nation. Our linguistic, ethnic, religious, and geographical variety makes India special, and that is our biggest strength. It is an exciting time to be an Indian, and it is an exciting time to be a Naga. Nagaland and the Northeast are central to the India story. Without the development of Nagaland, the development of India will be incomplete. We are entering the festive season. In a few weeks, we will celebrate Christmas and march into the new year. This is the time to be with family and friends. This is time for renewal of resolutions. And this is the time to work for peace and prosperity. Above all, it is a time to fulfill the dreams of the terrific young people of Nagaland. Thank you again for inviting me to this beautiful state, your Nagaland, my Nagaland, and our Nagaland. I compliment you once more on the anniversary of Nagaland's statehood. I wish you a very hornbill festival and a Merry Christmas. God bless you all. Thank you. Jai Hind.